Climate change has ushered in the so-called New Arctic. One of the hallmarks of this New Arctic is that it's warming faster than any other region on the planet. The rapid melting of Arctic sea ice has become one of the most important global indicators of climate change. Vast areas of ocean surface are seeing the light of day for the first time in thousands, if not millions, of years. New research tackles a big part of this question: the role of the Arctic Ocean itself in melting its own cover of ice. How much ice melts each summer depends on how much heat reaches it. The heat can attack on two fronts: the sun and the air temperature above, and from the ocean below. Above the ice, heat from the sun is fairly constant over long periods of time, and air temperature, though warmer than usual, can't account for all the ice loss. This leaves the ocean below. But why would the ocean melt the ice? First off, the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans are heating up, and warmer currents flow from these oceans into the Arctic. In fact, these currents carry enough heat to instantly melt the overlying ice cover. The reason they don't is because this warm water is also saltier, which means it's heavier, causing it to sink deeper into the ocean. The colder, fresher surface water above partially shields the ice from this warmth. The sun, besides directly melting the ice, is also warming the ocean water. Water is much darker than snow or ice, so it absorbs much more of this heat. And as more ice melts, the sun can reach larger areas of the ocean's surface. The sun, penetrating through thinner and more fragmented ice, works along with the heat from the ocean to create smaller ice flows. Think of the old solid ice as a bumper-to-bumper traffic jam where nothing moves. But as it clears, individual cars can move more freely. Similarly, these smaller ice flows can move faster and easier across the ocean. Increasing winds combined with these faster moving ice flows are stirring the ocean below, mixing the colder surface water with the warmer layers beneath it. And as more warm water reaches the surface, even more ice is melting, creating a loop that continually increases the melting. More heat, more meltwater, and more links between atmosphere and oceans as the ice retreats characterizes the new Arctic. These changes are driving a fresher, warmer, and more dynamic polar north, with huge ecological, economic, and social implications.